Well, good evening, Sumter School District boys and girls, and welcome to another evening of Reading with the Superintendent. As we've promised, each and every night we'll come to you with a special guest to read to make sure that you're engaging in the important process of exercising your brain through reading, and we will do so with a special guest. And tonight we have a special guest who actually was introduced with the music that we just shared. It's her favorite song. And so we needed to open up with that, but just to let you understand who we have tonight, I'm going to now introduce to you Miss Madison. Well, hello there, Miss Madison. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm just dandy. Thank you for joining me in reading.
You're welcome.
So why don't you tell our viewers a little bit about you?
Okay, my name is Madison. I go to Alistair Middle. I'm in eighth grade. I do competition cheer, and I am in pro team where we learn to be better leaders.
So tell me about cheering. I mean, I have a lot of friends who wish they could be cheerleaders when they were your age. So tell me what you like most about cheering.
I love like the bonds with all my teammates, and I love going to compete at different places.
Okay, bonding is important, and so is competition. But tonight we're not going to compete against one another because we're in this together. So what's your favorite color?
Mint green.
Mint green. So is that the lighter green?
Yes, ma'am.
So you know what my favorite color is? With the pattern of the mint green? Cotton candy pink. It's cute.
Yeah.
So let's go ahead and begin preparing to read tonight. And tonight we're going to read Dad, Jackie, and Me. I wonder who Jackie is. Do you know who Jackie is?
Yes, ma'am.
You do? So you want to tell us who it is, who he is, or would you rather go ahead and read?
We can just read it.
It's your choice. You tell me what you want. Okay, so we're going to read. But this book is written by Myron Yulberg, and it's illustrated by Colin Bootman. I love the illustration.
They're really pretty.
And so as we get ready to read, I want to make sure I have everybody's attention. So there's a call and response thing that I do. So are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Two, three, all eyes on me.
One, two, my eyes are on you.
Absolutely. So before we begin to read, I just want to bring the viewer's attention to this one page that's in our book. And it looks like a clipping from the newspaper, and it's very old. And it says that he was the Rookie of the Year, Jackie Robinson Games Award, on basis of all-around ability. Wow, this must have come from someone's album because it has tape markings. So it'll be very interesting to see when that article was written. So are you ready to do this, Madison?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. My ear was glued to the radio like every other ear in Brooklyn. It was opening day, 1947, and every kid in Brooklyn knew this was our year. The Dodgers were going to go all the way. We had Jackie Robinson, the first Negro player in Major League Baseball. As I listened to the game, the minutes melted into hours. The innings folded on to one another. I could see it all in my mind's eye, pitch after pitch, swing after swing. I dreamed of the day I could see it all for myself. Madison, do you like baseball?
Not really.
Not really. I grew up watching baseball because my grandmother loved watching baseball, even though she would yell things like touchdown and goal. Like, sorry, I didn't mean to talk about her, but she loved baseball.
Our neighborhood was only a short subway ride from Ebbets Field, home of the Dodgers, and their new first baseman. I love baseball. I love the Brooklyn Dodgers. I hated the New York Giants, and they hated Jackie Robinson.
Wow. Those are some powerful words. Wow. One day, my father came home early from work. He walked into my bedroom and announced, "We're going to Ebbets Field." He didn't say it out loud. My father was deaf, and so he signed the words with his hands. I couldn't believe it. Dad had never seemed to care much about baseball. "I want to meet Jackie Robinson," Dad signed. I was finally going to see a real game. Today, the Dodgers were playing the Giants, and we were going to cream them. I got my glove and ball, Dodgers cap, and scorecard. I stuck my lucky pencil behind my ear. As we went down the steps, I tossed the ball to Dad, but he'd never played baseball like me. He dropped it. Have you ever been to Brooklyn, New York?
I don't think so.
You haven't been
to New York City.
You've been to New York? Okay. Okay, so you've been to New York. Okay. All right, did you like it?
Yes, ma'am. I couldn't wait to get to the ballpark, but the whole ride I kept thinking, there's no way Dad can meet Jackie Robinson. Besides, Jackie does in a sign language. How would they talk to each other?
That's an important question. That's an important question. The line to get into Ebbets Field snaked around Sullivan Place and up to Bedford Avenue. My dad let me hold my ticket. I clutched it for dear life. Finally, we were through the turnstile. My dad held my hand as we moved with the rest of the crowd through the gloomy underbelly of the stadium, up the dark ramp. Then we tumbled into bright sunlight.
I shut my eyes against the glare. When I opened them again, my breath caught in my throat. I had never seen anything so perfect as the inside of Ebbets Field. There, laid out at my feet, was the emerald green field, each blade of grass reflecting the light from the afternoon sun. The angles of the field were sharply marked in two lines of white chalk. The dirt-based paths formed a perfect diamond carpet, dotted with fat canvas bags at each base and a black rubber plate at home. I knew, if I had lived to be 100, I would never see a sight so beautiful.
The big stadium. Hey, peanuts! Hey, hot dogs! Get them while they're hot! Dad and I sat on the right field line, right behind first base, Jackie's position. The Dodgers symphony was marching up and down the aisles, playing "The Worms Crawl In, The Worms Crawl Out." The music was ear-splitting. Dad couldn't hear it, but he laughed along with everyone else at the sight of the raggedy band's tattered clothes, cowbells, and whistles. When the game started and Jackie ran out on the field, Dad yelled real loud, "Jackie! Jackie! Jackie!" Only it didn't come out that way. It sounded like "Augie, Augie, Augie." Since my dad couldn't hear, he had no way of knowing what the words should sound like. Everyone looked at my dad. I looked at my shoes. I wonder what he's thinking at this time.
As Jackie stood at first base, the Giants began hooting and hollering. They called Jackie names, horrible names. "What are they saying?" Dad asked. "Bad things," I said. "Tell me." Some of those words I had to fingerspell. I knew no sign for them. Dad listened with a sad little smile on his face. In the ninth inning, Jackie bunted and belt the throw to first, then he stole second. On the next Dodgers hit, he moved to third. The score was tied at 4-4. The Giants pitcher took a long windup and Jackie dashed for home. We all jumped to our feet, yelling, "Jackie, Jackie, Jackie." "Aggie, aye, ah," Dad screamed. At this time, nobody seemed to notice. The heck with the Giants. They were nothing. We had Jackie Robinson.
He seems like he's having fun, though.
Yes, ma'am.
Every day when Dad came home from work, he started asking me questions, not about school, about baseball. He wanted to know everything I knew, especially about Jackie Robinson. What's Jackie's batting average? 0.247, I said. How's that figured? I explained. What's an RBI? He asked. Runs batted in. Fielding average, what's that mean? I told him. You teach me baseball, he signed. Okay, I said. One night, Dad came home with a baseball glove. Let's have a catch, he signed. We tossed the ball back and forth until Mom called us for supper. Dad missed the ball every time. The only way he could hold it was by trapping the ball against his chest with both hands. That had to hurt, but Dad just smiled. Jackie never drops the ball, he signed. He catches it with one hand, not like me. All the week we practiced, Dad dropped the ball the most every time, even when I threw it underhand. Throw it regular, Dad said.
Dad and I kept going to games whenever we could. Every time Jackie came out to his position, Dad chanted right along with the crowd. Jackie never looked over at us. He just stared down the line at the next hitter. One Sunday, the Dodgers were playing the St. Louis Cardinals. What a game. Our pitcher had no hitter going, and then it happened. On a simple grounder that he knew he couldn't beat, a Cardinal player crossed first base and spiked Jackie on purpose. 52,000 eyes popped, 26,000 jaws dropped, 26,000 tongues were still. Then, in that awful silence, my father jumped to his feet. No, he screamed, not fair. Ahie. The Brooklyn crowd went nuts. They leaped to their feet and joined my father. Jackie. The name bounced off the brick walls, climbed the iron girders, and rattled around under their wooden roof. Jackie just stood at first base, his face a blank mask, blood streaming down his leg. It was almost as if he didn't hear the crowd.
It's a lot of noise from a lot of people.
Yes, ma'am.
All that month, Dad and I followed everything Jackie did. We read and we reread every report of every game that was printed in the New York Daily News. Dad started a scrapbook. If there was any mention of Jackie Robinson, he cut out the article and pasted it in his scrapbook. The scrapbook got thicker. The Dodgers kept winning, and the opposing teams kept writing Jackie Robinson. But Jackie never reacted. He didn't even seem to notice. And he never complained. So I think this goes back to that first page of Dad's scrapbook. Remember when I showed those pictures from 1947?
Yes, ma'am. The Dodgers clinched the pennant that season when the Cards beat the Cubs. Dad and I went downtown the next day to see the big parade to honor Jackie. And back in the neighborhood, we had a block party to celebrate.
Have you ever been to a block party?
No, ma'am.
Neither have I. It didn't matter whether the Dodgers won the last game of the season, since we were already over the top. But Dad and I didn't care. We went to Ebbets Field anyway. We went to see Jackie Robinson. In the third inning, Jackie smacked the ball to the deep field, left field, for a double. Then he flew home like the wind, his feet barely touching the path. The Brooklyn crowd went crazy. Go, 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 Jackie! Go, 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 ahee! My dad screamed right along with them. Finally, late in the day, as deep shadows stretched across the infield, Jackie caught a line drive hit down the first baseline. It was the last out of the game. Wow. I bet that crowd went berserk.
As the crowd cheered, Jackie stood alone at first base, staring at the ball in his glove. Then he turned and threw it into the stands, right to my father. That's when my dad did something he had never done before. He reached up and caught the ball in his bare hand. I'm not sure, but I think I saw Jackie Robinson smile. My dad dropped the ball into my empty glove.
And just like that, the baseball season of 1947 was over. So I think this is a very powerful story. What do you think the most powerful moment you captured from this, Madison?
I think it was probably when the dad caught the ball. Because, you know, like, he wasn't very interested at baseball at first, and then he caught the ball, and I think it was, like really, like, an eye-opener.
Absolutely, and I love the way you stated that. I think it truly was an eye-opener. And so my takeaway was that his son never gave up on teaching dad. Played basketball, and he had a disability, a hearing impairment. But he never gave up on his dad, and he was never embarrassed by his dad, and he just continued to support his father. So I think it went both ways. I think this is a very powerful book in the work of looking at people being kind. And even when he went to the baseball game and he was chanting and it sounded a little different from everyone else, there was no mockery that occurred, not that was mentioned in this book. So I think this is very powerful in talking about speaking kindness. So I'm going to speak about kindness right now. And I'm going to speak about kindness as it relates to you. I've had a great time reading with you. Wonderful young lady. You're absolutely wonderful. Keep that smile. Keep going to cheer practice. Keep with those great grades. And I will see you soon. And maybe, since you and I aren't baseball fans, maybe I can find a baseball and bat and we can learn to be baseball fans together. How about that? But we have to do it secretly because I can't see anybody, have anybody see me miss the ball.
Yes, ma'am.
What do you think?
That's good.
So I want you to continue to make sure you don't stop believing, just like your favorite song. And for those who are watching, don't you stop believing either. So thank you for joining us. Thank you, Madison. Have a great evening, and we'll see you soon. Have a good one. Thank you, Madison.
You're welcome.
It's your favorite song, right?